Hello, Oasis family. Welcome to another online version of Oasis Devotions. Just want to say thanks for being a part of this experience where we've been looking at different Christmas carols and talking about some of their significance and meaning and the verses and scriptures that go along. It's just been a really good Advent season. And thanks to Joel for putting these together and inviting me to be a part of it on this Friday. So this week we've been looking at the hymn Joy to the World. And it's a pretty good, pretty common, pretty well-known Christmas carol. But I wonder, did you know that Joy to the World was not written as a Christmas carol? It was not written celebrating the first coming of Jesus. It was not written in connection with the Christmas story. It was written actually in connection with Psalm 98, which talks about the second coming of Christ. And we've kind of taken and shifted and excluded some verses so it connects more with the first coming and not the second coming of Christ. So I was down here working out in the basement of our barn. I got a little gym over there on the other side, and I was hanging out with the chickens over here and thought, you know what, this would be a great place to talk about some other things of Christmas that maybe we don't have entirely accurate. So take a look around wherever you are. If you're at home, maybe you have a nativity scene sitting around somewhere. And recently I was listening to a podcast, and even last night I watched a video with my family as we were doing devotions. And we began to really think about what else is not accurate when we think about our Christmas celebrations and depictions of that first Christmas. And so we looked at our nativity scene and we're like, oh man, there's some things in there that maybe shouldn't and maybe should be changed a little bit. And we talked about actually building a new one that might be a little bit more biblically accurate. So the first thing, the picture that we have of that first nativity is Mary coming to Bethlehem on the back of a donkey. And when you look at some of the backstory and some of the language that was used in the writing of this story, that's probably not entirely accurate. She probably was not riding on the back of a donkey. Just logistically thinking, she's 9 months pregnant on the back of a donkey riding 16 miles. That probably would not have been a good idea. So most likely she was probably in a cart that was being drawn by a donkey and led by Joseph. And then it talks about in our idea of what that story looks like, we hear about an innkeeper and how they went to the innkeeper and how he says there's no room in the inn. And we think about this hotel. Well, innkeeper is probably not a good translation of that word or what happened, and it wasn't a hotel, it was probably somebody's house, and there being no room, so they went to the stable or to the barn or whatever you want to call it, because there was no room in the inn, so they went out to where the animals were. Well, most likely they went to a cave, not to this nice little barn looking thing with a wood shingled roof like we have sitting on our mantles. It was probably a cave, or more likely it was the basement of the house where they kept the animals. Not a barn looking thing like we create. So yeah, there's some differences there that may cause us to question this story, or this depiction of the story that we have in our head. And just think about the wise men, or we sing the song Three Kings. They weren't kings, they were wise men, they were astrologers, and we hear in scripture of three gifts that were brought, so we just associate that there was three of them, but no, there was probably many, many more, as many as 10, 20, maybe even 30 of these wise men. There could have been a whole entourage of them. So we have these pieces of the story that are not entirely accurate, but that's okay, because the fact of the Christmas story is that God sent his son Jesus to be born of a virgin, Mary, and he is to be the joy of the world, bring joy to the world like we have not experienced There's a passage in John 16, I believe, where Jesus is talking to his disciples, and he says, he's talking about their sadness being turned into joy. And as I think about joy to the world in this Christmas season and the details that maybe we don't have entirely accurate, that's okay. Because right now, there's a lot of sadness. Right now, there's a lot of hurt. Right now, there's a lot of pain. Right now, there's a lot of isolation and depression. There's a whole lot. But like Jesus told his disciples, soon their sadness will be turned into joy. I'm telling you, and God's telling you today, that soon your sadness will be turned into joy, because Jesus came as joy to the world. As the song sings, joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Joy to the world. This is a great song, and I hope you don't think any less of it now that you're like, oh, it's not even a Christmas song. Maybe we'll sing it this summer. We'll bust it back out or even during Easter. We'll sing it some other times to remind us that it's not just a Christmas hymn, but it's for all seasons and all times of the year, because it's talking about his second coming, and that should bring a huge sense of joy to each and every one of us, no matter the situation, no matter the circumstances we find ourselves in, because he is the joy of the world, and he can bring joy. Situations don't bring us joy. He alone can bring us true joy. So I'm praying for you. I'm excited for this season, and next week is Christmas. So let's pray and look forward to all that God has for us. God, thank you for this time that we could spend talking about joy to the world. And I thank you that you sent Jesus to be our joy, that our joy is not based on the situations around us, but God, our joy can be focused and fixed on you. So God, I just pray that in this season, our eyes would be lifted from all the circumstances around us, and we would see you, and our joy would be restored. Thank you for sending Christ, joy to the world. The King has come. Amen.